Man, I'm all about, you know, building bridges and not barriers, you know. So I think a lot of times people will put you in a box, and that box says, I don't want anybody not like me inside this box. I just am wrapping up a project I did with Zaytoven. We did one with Waka Flocka, and it's crazy. I'm gonna let y'all hear a little sneak peek.
Get rich off of dope if you let them tell it. Get a scale and a bowl, head up and sell it. They got rich off of Kush if you let them tell it.
You think about Kanye, and Kanye had his car accident, and that changed his perspective on things, and he wasn't afraid to like put his personal struggles and his spiritual stuff on display. Same kind of thing happened to me. So
early in your career, you've been qualified as a Christian rapper,
mm-hmm.
and this what I would call sub-genre of Christian rap, which is very specific to the US. You also won a Grammy for Best Christian Song, correct?
Mm-hmm.
What did it do for your career, and what's your relationship to this term now?
I mean, people like categories. You know, people use them to figure out stuff, so I understand it. I don't necessarily hold on to those because they don't really define me, like who I really and truly am. Elvis Presley won his only Grammy in gospel, but you know, he's not just a gospel artist. I'm not ashamed to embrace my Christian faith or anything like that, but I think when people say that, they have all these ideas in their mind of what that looks like or what that means. People get mad, you know, I do a song with Ty Dolla $ign or Big Crit or whoever, and then they're like, wait, what are you doing? I thought you were a Christian. I'm like, but see, you have this idea of how this is supposed to be. Mm-hmm. Like, that doesn't mean that's how it is. That's your idea of it.
Recently, you've opened up your music a little more.
Yeah.
Especially with the last project, All Things Work Together.
Yeah. I mean, you got Boy Wonder, Metro Boomin, A-plus Ear Drummers, of course, Tori Kelly, and Ty Dolla $ign.
Just hold on and I'll find you.
I'm hanging on by a thread, and all I'm clinging to is prayers. And every breath is like a battle, I feel like I ain't come prepared.
I've been down before to come up, I ain't stressing. Baby, I'm too busy counting all these blessings.
Talking about the music, you've been pushing it more beyond the US. You have a concert coming up in Paris.
Yeah.
Why does it matter for you to push it beyond the US?
Music belongs to the world. Like, the world should be able to experience it. In the States, music is kind of like trendy. It's like, all right, next. And I feel like in Europe, y'all tend to like appreciate stuff. If you like it, you like it for a longer period of time.
Do you feel like the kind of music that you do matters even more in Trump's America?
Oh, y'all care about that overseas too?
They do, very much.
Yeah, for sure. Because what I do is I remind people, you know, your hope is not in circumstances, and that there's hope in chaos. So when it looks very chaotic, you don't have to be like, I'm done. The circumstance may not be okay, but overall, you'll be fine. You know, I ain't been on Twitter in a long time because everyone's complaining. So much negativity. Like, you forget you woke up this morning. You know, you forget, like, oh, I'm alive.
Three artists that you love to work with.
I want to work with 2 Chainz. 2 Chainz is kind of like the trap goat. It's like clever, wise, but like it's still like hood. Kanye, he's legendary. You know, I think he's a genius in a lot of ways, and he's reinvented himself a million times. So I take notes on that. You know what I do? I do want to do a session before he just downright retires and never does anything else again with Dr. Dre. Because I saw what Dre did with like with Snoop and with Kendrick, and I hear about his process, and I'm just always interested in like, man, what would
it's rim. Well, a ritual is pretty much a rite of passage is what it is. A ritual's definition is a religious or solemn ceremony consisting of a series of actions performed according to a prescribed order. The ritual summons the god or the demon, but the blood satisfies them. This is where child sacrifices start. To pay for your gift from the gods, you must sacrifice your gift from God above. You must pay with a human life like Cain did. So rituals include dancing, sex, chanting, astral sex, false tongues, tattoos, marks, self-inflicted pain, ritual pain, cutting, bleeding, drug use, drunkenness, transcendental meditation, yoga, homosexual sex. It's all ritual praise to the gods. Serenade is, during the ritual, music is of the utmost importance because the ritual gives you rite of passage. But the music plays the frequencies needed to summon the gods and cross them over into our plane. We summon whom we serenade. Taking the music of a song with a message that was negative and trying to change the message to positive is impossible because your brain has already accepted the song's message. Your mind has mind-stamped the song's frequencies and related them to the original message. It is impossible to change that stamp. Even though you sing new words with your mouth, your body and chemicals have recorded the music, and thus the original message is still prevalent in your mind. The industry knows that you can sing or speak positive words but emit negative energy at the same time. This is why they give their artists a positive song every now and then, but because the intent is evil, they are able to emit resonant frequencies that defile you even with a positive message. Holy Hip Hop is a prime example of this. The true intent of the artist is self-promotion, bragging, swagger, etc., but the message is Christ. This is why they continually fall into sin, promote the same lifestyle of the real hip-hoppers, you know, the piercings, tattoos, sagging, grill, all that, but speak positive in their raps. They even copy the resonant frequencies of the Illuminati's music and put positive lyrics over that. This is the same as having a clean version versus an explicit one. The intent of the music remains, and it changes your thought process. It's a trick to make you resonate to the industry standards. You can't redeem music because it's not matter. It's a particle. You can't redeem hip-hop because it's an idea, not a living soul. Only man is a living soul. If he could redeem hip-hop, then you could be able to redeem animals, devils, and demons. None are living souls, only man. You can't redeem music because it's not matter. It's a particle. You can't redeem hip-hop because it's an idea, not a living soul. Only man is a living soul. If he could redeem hip-hop, then you could be able to redeem animals, devils, and demons. None are living souls, only man. This is why God's music must originate with what? His intent. It cannot be a copy. Evil in music possesses evil energy and intent. It's not about the words. Look at somebody say it's not about the words. As much as it is the intent. People react to the intent or energy of the artist's resonant frequencies as well, not just the lyrics. It's not about what you're saying. It's about what you're feeling and doing, your intent. The Bible talks about this, and it calls it death and life are in the... Wait, stop, don't clap. It's not in the tongue. It's not in what you're saying. It's in the... What is power? Energy. Light. Power of the tongue. Yod means hand. Hand is what you move stuff with and arrange things with. Power of the tongue. Intent. Can I keep preaching? Need another Bible example? Jesus did it. Jesus walked by a fig tree. He was hungry, and the fig tree didn't live up to its name. Jesus cursed it. You won't bear anything else. They came back, fig tree was with it. Now when Jesus does it, it doesn't take 30 days. It's like instant, because he is the Son of the Most High God. You think it understood Jesus' language? It is intent. Can I keep going? Ain't this good? Hip-hop is the genre of choice of the Illuminati because it's simplistic enough so as to not stimulate thought, but allow our receptors to be free to receive the message and the intent. Sampling music simplifies it even more because the mind is already trained by the old school hit, and thus you are not only receiving a new sinful message with intent, but you now take on the original intent of the sample as well. The enemy has created an army of blind followers that defend their demise and shun truth for the sake of their musical drugs. I hear musical medicine, musical alchemy. This is good stuff right here, y'all. Y'all gonna give me some time, right? Find a person that says they love all kinds of music or they listen to all kinds of music, and then the world calls them eclectic. But they are usually emotional wrecks. They depend on music because it's a drug to them. This guy, Richard Pellegrino, is a brain surgeon, and he works in the trauma ward in the hospital. People come in the hospital high on heroin. And so in order to get them off the heroin, get them off the high, because they're about to die. They're right at the edge, about to die from an overdose. So he gives them naloxone, which is a drug. That drug, the drug binds to the opium receptors of the brain. And then when heroin is bound to these receptors, it kicks it out and takes their high down. Well, he said, if you find a group of people that love music or love a certain artist or whatever, when you give them the same naloxone, it changes the way they feel about the artist. Because what happens is these people with the opium that's on the heroin, when they take this naloxone, they jump up swinging and fighting. And the doctor's like, what's wrong? You messed up my high. But you was about to die. Yeah, but you messed up my high. But you were about to die. The same thing, it binds, music binds to the same receptor. So he gave this same medication to some people that were crazy about music and they lost the desire for their music. What does that tell us? That tells us that when I try to take your music away, you come up swinging. No! Don't take my music away.
Hey everybody, this is Eric, EJ Love. Just wanted to get back to you today and do a little video on 116, Reach Records, Lecrae, the whole crew promoting the Light Bearer Initiative, I guess you could say. That's right, Light Bearer. Now, for those of us who know what the Word of God says, for those of us who believe what the Word of God says, we know that the term or phrase light bearer is used in reference to Lucifer. And I will actually prove that today. I'm not just going to say it, but I'll actually prove it. I know there may have been some other people who might have done videos about this, but I pray that this video will be a blessing and, Lord willing, be the most thorough yet that has been released. And I pray that there's anybody else who has any insight on this information, on this topic at hand, that they will do the same thing as the Lord leads and release that information, basically exposing the light bearer, as this is the initiative of Reach Records and 116. And that clip that I just played was from their song Lightwork. It's Reach Records, 116, Lecrae, Andy Mineo, Triple E, you know, those guys. I don't know if you could tell, but it really didn't sound any different than worldly music. But, you know, I'm probably just being a legalist and a Pharisee, and I probably have a religious spirit I'm sure I'll be accused of. But I have a video coming on that as well, so we're not going to dive into that just yet. But there will be a video being released about the Pharisee and what a Pharisee is and what a Pharisee is not. So we're on Reach Records merch line. It's their, I guess you could say, their merchandise website. It's linked up from their Instagram page. And we see the light bearer is just really being heavily promoted. I can zoom in on it. I'm sure you see it. You can also, you know, find this easily online for yourself. We just see how they're really, really promoting this whole light bearer thing. They're even using this young lady here. And I mean, I don't know about you, but her how she's posing and the look on her face, it just seems like it really attracts lust. It seems like a really lustful type of picture, if you ask me. And they're like, oh, Eric, you're just reaching. You're being a Pharisee. She's completely covered up. Yeah, but look at her eyes. Look at her face. It just seems really lustful while they're promoting this light bearer. And who is the light bearer? Well, we're going to get into that. Look at that. Some one-eye symbolism. More light bearer stuff. More light bearer promotion. You know, they got light bearer phone cases. They got light bearer t-shirts, hoodies, jackets. I mean, you name it. I mean, I don't know. Here we got some more one-eye symbolism with this light bearer phone case. So, we're going to get into some scriptures in regards to who is that counterfeit light, that light bearer, and also get into scriptures in regards to who is that real light. Alright, so you get the point. There's the merchandise, there's the shirts, there's that lustful model. And this is their Instagram page. Pretty much some of the same stuff. And they've been promoting this pretty much all year. Oh, let's see. They even got a billboard. They got a billboard in Houston, Texas promoting this. I mean, that's wild to me, if you ask me, but alright. So, some more pictures. We'll go through this a little bit, but you get the point. So anyways, I want to go to Blue Letter Bible. And we're going to pull up or do a search for Lucifer. Now, mind you, you have to use the King James Bible because the King James Bible in English is pretty much the only Bible who uses Lucifer, who uses the word, the name Lucifer in Isaiah 14:12. Now, obviously, Bibles that may have came before the King James Bible may use Lucifer as well. But I'm sure the vast majority of us don't use, you know, the Wycliffe Bible or the Tyndale Bible or the Geneva Bible or the Bishop's Bible and so on and so forth. But we do use the King James Bible. And this will be the only Bible, modern Bible that we have available to us that actually uses Lucifer in Isaiah 14 and 12. So we'll just go ahead and see what this pulls up. Alright, so here we have Isaiah 14 and 12. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? And we'll go forward again. And we know in Hebrew, Lucifer is Halel. Obviously, Lucifer is like, that's transliteration, is Halel. And we know that Lucifer is basically from the Latin. And a lot of people say, oh, it's a mistranslation. That word's not supposed to be there. Look, I'll tell you like this. I trust the Lord and who He chose to put together that King James Bible and those translators who translated it. I trust their scholarship and their knowledge and understanding of the word and the scriptures better than any James White, the heretic. Yeah, I said it. I'm probably going to make a lot of people mad who sees this video. I believe James White is a heretic. And any other textual critic who comes against the King James Bible. And no, I'm not a Ruckmanite either. So don't throw me in that camp and don't refer to me as a King James onlyist. And I believe in King James onlyism. I don't espouse to any of your titles or any of your little, whatever you want to box people in, your little labels and stuff. We don't espouse to that over here, so yeah, you can kick rocks with all that. I'm not pulling any punches with this video, I'm going to tell you right now. So, Lucifer equals light bearer. Now let me zoom in on that if you can't see that good enough. Shining one, morning star, Lucifer, of the king of Babylon and Satan. Hallel, describing the king of Babylon. Lucifer is the light bearer. Do you see that? Do we see that? Lucifer equals light bearer. So why would Reach Records, 116, Lecrae, and these fellas, why would they name their initiative and their clothing light bearer? Well, I think it's quite simple, to be honest. Let me pull up 2 Corinthians chapter 11. You know, I think we'll just go ahead and read vast majority of this chapter, at least half this chapter, in context. Alright, so, it says, "Would to God ye could bear with me a little in my folly, and indeed bear with me." "For I am jealous over you with godly jealousy. For I have espoused you to one husband, that I may present you as a chaste virgin to Christ. But I fear, lest by any means, as the serpent beguiled Eve through his subtlety, yet so your mind should be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ." See, there's simplicity in Christ. We don't have to do all these initiatives. Like, there's simplicity in Christ. Everything doesn't have to be a trend, a hashtag, something people can, you know... I'm sorry. Let me not get sidetracked. "For if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus..." See, I'm always told there's no other Jesus. Let me read that again. "For if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus, whom we have not preached, or if ye receive another spirit, which ye have not received, or another gospel, which ye have not accepted, ye might well bear with him. For such are false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of Christ. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works." See, friends, there is another Jesus that is preached. There's another spirit that's being received. And there's another gospel that's being preached, as Paul mentioned in Galatians 1, 6 through 9. We'll just actually read 6 through 10. "I marvel that ye are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel, which is not another, but there be some that trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. As we said before, so say I now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that ye have received, let him be accursed. For do I now persuade men or God, or do I seek to please men? For if I yet please men, I should not be the servant of Christ." And see, we know that these men, unfortunately, they want to be pleasers of men. They're trying to be pleasers of men. You know, that's why you have Lecrae yoking up with worldly individuals, worldly rappers. But I will say this, you know, the Word of God tells us that we are not to be unequally yoked together with unbelievers, and that we cannot serve two creators. We cannot serve two gods, rather. So, you know, Lecrae, he is an open and known Kappa Alpha Psi. And to become a member of the Kappa Alpha Psi fraternity, you have to bow down at the altar of Apollo. Now, he never rejected this, and he still promotes his Kappa Alpha Psi membership. So, with that being said, I mean... what God are you really serving? You know what I mean? And this is the the beginning rituals that they do to become a member. But yeah, I've actually been in contact with with a former member of this fraternity, and he was filling me in on all of this. You know, he has the the ritual books, and he also has ritual books from other fraternities as well, like Alpha Phi Alpha and Omega Psi Phi, and these types of fraternities, these Greek letter organizations. And I mean, and all these different Greek letter organizations, you have to bow down to false gods. And Lecrae had to become a Kappa Alpha Psi, which he still represents. That means he bowed down on the altar of Apollo, and he's never forsaken it. He's never forsaken that. There's other Christians, so-called Christians, who are a member of this. Jamal Bryant. And what's that other guy's name? Marvin Sapp and Montel Jordan, Smokey Norful, Colin Kaepernick. You know, these people are all Kappa Alpha Psi's. You know, and Lecrae, he's yoked up doing music with worldly rappers. He's signed to Columbia Records. So I ask, you know, what gospel is actually being preached? Is it the gospel according to the Word of God, or is it another gospel? You know, what Jesus is being preached? Is it the Jesus according to the Scriptures, or is it another Jesus? Is it another spirit? So, you know, I just think it's quite telling that this is who so many of the youth are looking up to. And I don't blame the youth, don't get me wrong. I don't blame the youth one bit. They may not know any different. And I know a lot of Lecrae fans, 116 fans. I mean, I've dealt with them by going out preaching at their events and going to these different conferences. And they really ride or die for Lecrae. And they'll say I'm a legalist. They'll say I'm a Pharisee. But why? Because I'm exposing, I'm reproving the unfruitful works of darkness, like it tells us to do in Ephesians 5:11. And it actually tells us, you know, to not just reprove them. But let's read what else it says. It says, and have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. So we're not to even have fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness. That means we're not to be yoked together, unequally yoked together with unbelievers. You know, music was created strictly for the worship and praise of God. So, as a Christian artist, well, or you'd rather not be considered a Christian artist, Lecrae, but as somebody who makes music and you just happen to be a Christian, if your music that's being made is not glorifying God, then who is it glorifying? I mean, I've seen plenty of Lecrae, Andy Mineo, 116 videos, you know, and songs, and I used to listen to Lecrae, and I had to repent of that. And, you know, as Lecrae has gone on, I mean, in his music, he barely even mentions the name of Jesus anymore. He barely mentions Jesus. Most of these guys barely mention Jesus in their music anymore. You know, and again, it's no small thing, you know, that Satan, that he will have, you know, ministers of righteousness, so to speak, you know, transforming themselves, you know, that they're transformed as ministers of righteousness, but they're really not. They're ministers of Satan. You know, so Light Bearer Initiative, the Lucifer Initiative. You know, you can just type in Light Bearer. And like a Wikipedia result, first thing that pulls up, Wikipedia, Lightbearer, Lucifer, called Lightbearer, as the Latin word Lucifer means light bringing. Lucifer, the Lightbearer. I mean, come on. I mean, really? So basically, your initiative is the Lucifer Initiative, which I understand because, see, Freemasons, at the highest levels, they worship Lucifer. That's who Freemasons worship. And I believe there's obviously in these different fraternities, Greek letter organization, no matter what fraternity and sorority it is, they all link back to Freemasonry. You know, you go through rituals, you go through ceremonies, initiations, and to excel up in the ranks, to get to higher levels and higher statuses, you got to do certain things. You know, just as in Freemasonry, you know, to get to the next degree, you have to do certain things to get to the next degree. So, I just find it quite strange that they would want to, refer to their initiative as the Light Bearer Initiative. You know, you type in Light Bearer, and what comes up? Oh, look at that, Freemasonry, of course it does. You know, Lucifer, Light Bearer. You know, I didn't do a lot of, I mean, because most of this is common knowledge, honestly, and you can just easily Google all this stuff for yourself, you know, to look into Lucifer. I mean, I wouldn't look into it too heavily, because ultimately we got to go after the real light. We gotta study the real light. And by studying the real light, by knowing who the real light is, it will show you who the darkness is. I can go to Lecrae's Instagram right now and tell you it's not about Jesus. I mean, there's barely anything on his Instagram that even points me to the Lord or in his lyrics. I mean, here we got, you know, the Light Bearer, light work, you know. Where's that picture at? Here we got him looking like he's a gangster with the ski mask or whatever, or his face covered. Here we got, you know, his own shoes. Here we got a doll made of him. And what is that doll doing? Throwing up the horns. Now, does that seem like a Light Bearer to you? And I know people are going to say, oh, well, that's the H. That's the H for H-Town. So when does fleeing all appearance or abstaining from all appearance of evil apply? I mean, come on, seriously? Here he is throwing up the horns again, Houston, Texas. Oh, it's all for H-Town. Come on, man. You know that's the devil horns. Quit playing with me. You know, and honestly, at this point, I don't even have, like, I'm not going to be, you know, all, like, compassionate towards them about this. Because they've been warned and they've been shown the truth. And all Lecrae does, and Andy Mineo, is all they do, like, in interviews and whatnot, they just mock. They will mock and they'll say, oh, about the whole pyramid. Oh, I guess I'm Illuminati, right?
I didn't, but you know what's funny? We always, nowadays, everything we do, we think, we're always like laughing because we're like, I wonder what they're going to find in this one to think it's Illuminati. I thought just us being upside down alone was going to be enough for them to say I was an Illuminati. Like, but no, I didn't. I was thinking steeple, but I guess triangles are somehow they represent some kind of secret society. So I got to talk to my kids because they have been doing a lot of geometry lately. So I wonder if the teachers are inducting them in some kind of Illuminati activity. I need to find out about this. It's getting crazy out here, man. Geometry, steeples. If you didn't know, Peace Preparatory Academy in Atlanta, English Avenue, man. You know, support, look it up, and, you know, get the baby some education. Get him away from these evil triangles. Ridiculous. There's only octagons, squares, and circles being taught at this school.
You know, I better not let my children, you know, are doing, geometry or whatever. Oh, it must be Illuminati, right? You know, with all the triangles and stuff. I mean, he just mocks it, man. The guy is very condescending and very mocking. And I mean, it just shows to me what spirit is working through him. Instead of actually sitting back and being like, you know what? Maybe people are saying this for a reason. Maybe they're saying this, you know, maybe this is something I should actually take a look at. You know, examine myself. You know, seriously. I mean, come on. Here he is with Chance the Rapper. You know, I'm not going to get too deep in it. Here he is repping his fellow brother, Kappa Alpha Psi member, Colin Kaepernick. Because, you know, that's another thing, you know. We're to call no man, no woman, you know, whatever. Our brother, our sister, our mother, you know, except those that do the will of the Father. You know, Jesus said those that do the will of the Father, which is in heaven, are his mother and his brother and his sister. So when you're calling these different people in these different fraternities your brother or your sister in the sorority, yeah, I don't think so. I mean, because here's the thing. To be a Freemason, the number one prerequisite for being a Freemason is you have to believe in a God. Atheists cannot be a Freemason. They don't care if you believe in Krishna and Buddha and Muhammad or, you know, God of the Bible, Jesus Christ. They don't care as long as you believe in a God. You can believe in Confucius. You can believe in Zoroastrianism, Mormonism, doesn't matter. But you have to believe in a God. In a God. You know, and so these are the people you're yoking up with. These are the people you're calling your brother and your sister. You know, so I just wanted to share that quickly. Yeah, the light bearer. The light bearer is Lucifer. But who is the light according to Scripture? I'll just read a few scriptures here. Let's see. You can see that, maybe, maybe not. Jesus said, "Ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it gives light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven." Amen. Matthew 6:22-23 it says, "The light of the body is the eye. If therefore thine eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light. But if thine eye be evil, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is that darkness?" Matthew 10:27. "What I tell you in darkness, that speak ye in the light. And what ye hear in the ear, that preach ye upon the housetops." Amen. Let's see. Luke 11:33 and down. "No man, when he hath lighted a candle, put it in a secret place, neither under a bushel, but on a candlestick, that they which come in may see the light." The light of the body is the eye. Therefore, when thine eye is single, thy whole body also is full of light. But when thine eye is evil, thy body is also full of darkness. Take heed, therefore, that the light which is in thee be not darkness. If thy whole body, therefore, be full of light, having no part dark, the whole shall be full of light, as when the bright shining of a candle doth give thee light. Therefore, whatsoever ye have spoken in the darkness shall be heard in the light, and that which ye have spoken in the ear in closet shall be proclaimed upon the housetops." Amen. Let's see. John 3:19. "And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in God." Amen. Jesus said, "As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world." So Jesus is the true light. Satan is a counterfeiter. As we touched on a little bit earlier. Jesus, we see, is the real light. He said, "Then Jesus said unto them, Yet a little while is the light with you. Walk while ye have the light, lest darkness come upon you. For he that walketh in darkness knoweth not whither he goeth. While ye have light, believe in the light, that ye may be the children of light. These things spake Jesus, and departed, and did hide himself from them." And he goes on and says, "I am come a light into the world, that whosoever believeth on me should not abide in darkness." Acts 13:47. This is another good one to use against Hebrew Israelites. "For so hath the Lord commanded us, saying, I have set thee to be a light of the Gentiles, that thou shouldest be for salvation unto the ends of the earth." Amen. Jesus spoke this to Paul. "To open their eyes and to turn them from darkness to light and from the power of Satan unto God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and inheritance among them which are sanctified by faith that is in me." Amen. Let's see. Second Corinthians 4. It says in verse 3, "But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, hath shined in our hearts, to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ." Amen. Second Corinthians 6:14. "Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers, for what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness, and what communion hath light with darkness?" Ephesians 5:8. "For ye were sometimes darkness, but now are ye light in the Lord. Walk as children of the light." Ephesians 5:13. "But all things that are reproved are made manifest by the light, for whatsoever doth make manifest is light." 14. "Wherefore he saith, Awake thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light." So, we get the point on the scriptures. That's a good place to stop for that.